Hey, how you doing today? This is a video on how to take care of those hard keepers. This is my hard keeper. He's a 2-year-old thoroughbred gelding. He's 17 hands, so he eats a ton of food. So we've kind of narrowed down his diet now, and he's doing real well. As you can see, he's got a real nice shiny coat. He's still a little, I'd say, in my book, he needs a little bit more weight, but he's getting there. So, but I'll share with you what I feed him. He's my love. He likes to give kisses. Yes, he gives good kisses, don't you? Yes. So anyway, Ab gets I feed Nutrina maintenance feed for him. It's formulated with rice bran, so it helps give him some. He says, "Give me some more, Mom." It helps give him a little bit more calories, so he gets 2 full scoops of that in the morning and 2 full scoops of that at night. And when I'm saying full scoops, I mean loaded full scoop. He gets 2 of these in the morning and at night. He also gets 1.5 scoops of beet pulp. It's by the Stanley Beet Pulp at Tractor Supply, about $13 a bag. So he gets 1.5 scoops of those a day. And then switched over to these alfalfa pellets now. I really like them a lot better than the cubes. They soak up water a lot quicker. So if I do forget to set it up the night before, I can set it up while I'm cleaning stalls in the morning before I bring everybody in from night. So he gets 1.5 of those every morning. And then he does get 4 pumps of the coca soy oil on his feed every morning as well. So the coca soy oil, again, helps coat, helps feet, helps maintain weight. So if you have a hard keeper, I recommend beet pulp. He is particular about his beet pulp. He has to have the shreds. He won't eat the pellets. So if you do have a picky eater, try the different types that they sell. So my mare over there doesn't like beet pulp at all. We have to put stuff in it to get her to eat it. So and then try alfalfa cubes. If you're worried about them getting too much energy from the alfalfa, I mean, he's 2 and he doesn't seem to, but they do also make Timothy cubes as well. Oh, and he does get 3 big flakes of hay every day as well. And he gets about 12 hours of turnout at night. He goes out all night long as well on a nice green pasture. So that's just a few tips. Love the coca soy oil. Been using it for 20 years now, I think. It's just awesome, and it smells so good when you're mixing up feed in the morning. He does get biotin for his feet as well, and I am ordering flaxseed for him as well, which is a really good omega oil, which is supposed to be awesome for their coat and their feet and everything. I've given the coat cookies, I'm trying to think who makes them. I did that all show season last year with my little mare, and they made her black as could be. She was beautiful, but I've been reading up on saving money, and they're pretty much made with flaxseed and all the omega oils that flaxseed contains. So I'm going to try just flaxseeds this year and see if that helps darken them up, because as you can see, he's black. She is black. She is a dark bay. But on those cookies last year, she got really, really dark, and she got black last year. She's a fading black, but she stays out of the sun all day. So try those, or try and get some flaxseed. You know, you can get it, buy a little bag of it. It's not too expensive. I'm going to try and find a 50-pound bag of it to see how it works, because I have 4 horses. So, say hi, Ab. Say hi, Ab. oh, thank you for the frosty glasses. So I'll be feeding quite a bit of it because I do have two show horses and a mini show horse. But anyway, these are just a few tips that I've found out that really help keep weight on a horse. Like I said, beet pulp is probably your best bet if you're worried about too much energy. It doesn't really give them a lot of energy like their alfalfa would. But hope this helps. Ask any questions in the comments that you might have, and hopefully I could help you out a little bit more.